I have seen a man die in this game. We are bled on the battlefield.
Again, the fight game is full of sharks, but I'm the fucking whale.
Making sure your internal dialogue and your internal belief in yourself is strong.
If you truly
enough.
Know yourself, you can know others. So I know what way I feel. I know what way that man feels.
Secret and preaching the law of attraction.
You believe in it, you will succeed.
What got me to where I am and where I continue to go and where I will continue to go is an insane work ethic. You can only put in that amount of work if you were doing something that you are passionate about. And that's what I have engaged my entire life's work in. You cannot fully commit to something if you are not passionate about it. So you must look at your surroundings, at the things you are involved in, and ask yourself, are you truly passionate about these things? Do you truly want to put every ounce of your being into these things? And I am blessed, truly, truly blessed by something. I am not sure what it is, but I am blessed that I was able to find my passions. These avenues that the fight game has opened up for me, I'm going down them at 100 mile an hour with no brakes and full confidence in what lies ahead. And great things are happening. So I'm very, very blessed and very motivated still. I have gone through times in my young career of lapses in motivation and seeking that energy. But you know, I'm not supposed to be here. Where I come from, it's on my whiskey proper number 12. I come from a place, Dublin 12. It is a hard-working town, a small little suburb. It has its good and it has plenty of bad, but I always like to focus on the good because the good shines through. Where I come from, we're not supposed to climb to these heights. We're told that. It's instilled in us. And I wanted to break that mold and pave the way, open up paths. You know, like driving on them towards them building sites, and I'm just a young kid, first year apprentice plumber on a building site. They're the guy that goes to make the tea. They're the guy that goes and gets the copper pipes from the storehouse and carries it up. It's the hard work that's not respected and not admired. And I was on them building sites cold and damp, and I was like looking around at fully qualified people on the site and their postures not right. That was not me. You know, I knew I could do something better. I knew I had something in me. I was training for the fight game, but no one in Ireland had made it in the fight game. An Irish man in the UFC was literally, and I mean literally, laughed at. We were laughed at when I said we were going to get to the UFC. Myself and my team were going to get to the UFC. Never mind get a win. Never mind even get a win in the UFC. Then win a belt, then win the second belt. You know, I've just used all that fuel that I'm not supposed to do it, but I'm going to do it. And I'm going to outwork everyone that says I cannot do it. And that's what I did. And that's how I rose up. And long may it continue. So my sister, when I was a young kid at around 15 years of age, unsure where I was going, came to me with a book, The Secret, and preaching the law of attraction. Yeah. I wasn't interested. I was almost laughing at it. But then she kept on me with it, and I eventually watched a movie on it and read some books on it. And then it started to resonate with me, like to keep positive and have belief in where you're going. And you're able to, you can almost visually create your entire world. No, not almost, you actually can. I'm going to do that, and I will do that. And then that's when I began to practice it. I used to drive, my girlfriend, we used to drive to a food place in like a shopping mall in Ireland, and it was a very busy shopping mall. And I would practice like little parts of it. Like when we were driving into the shopping mall,
the car park, I would always visualize that the car park space right at the front door would be empty for me, waiting for us to pull up. And sometimes I'd get it and sometimes I wouldn't get it. You know, but when I got it, I celebrated like I just won my double world title. You know, and I kept building on that and I got better at it. And I became so damn good at it that I was able to go into bouts against undefeated fighters with insane fighting legacies. And I was able to go in front of the world and tell the world, I'm going to knock this man out with this exact shot at this exact time. And I done it back to back to back. See, I was visualizing before I even knew about it. Obviously, soccer is huge in Ireland and the UK. Yeah. And it was my first love, most certainly. I used to sneak out of the house late at night, and there used to be a little grass patch by my home. And I would take the football out and play on the grass patch on my own. And I would kick the ball against the wall. And when I kicked the ball against the wall, I would imagine it was a goal. And I scored a goal, and I would run off. And I would visualize a screaming arena cheering me on. And they were my first visions of selling out arenas and you know, and doing these type of things. Although it didn't end up in the football game, I ended up in a similar one. So it all worked out, and it was all true visualization. So I was just like, who am I? Yes. I know who I am. I am an Irish animal, a proper Irish animal. My career is a career of never been done before. No Irish man has done what I have done. I opened up pathways for my people. We came steaming through the door thanks to my belief and my hard work. I put my people on, I put my nation on the map. Although we are known as the Fighting Irish, in boxing terms, we have a rich history in boxing, but not in mixed martial arts, true fighting, a full fight. We had zero history, zero impact. We were almost looked down upon. The UK scene had risen up. There was many stars. Of course, the Brazilians, they invented the sport, Vale Tudo, no holds barred fighting. Then the Americans took it, franchised it into the UFC and built it up to what it was.
Yeah.
So the Americans and the Brazilians dominated the sport. And then the UK was rising up, and the Irish were just the Irish. Yes. But
I knew more. Different.
No more, exactly.
Give
exactly.
it up for him. That's now, awesome, man.
Now my nation's flag is on the UFC belt. They released a new belt. I won the two belts, the first to ever done it, the first to ever, and still the only two ever do it, yes. Unified. You know, for so long, like in my mid to late 20s, when I started to acquire wealth and acquire money, I was fascinated with materialistic things. I would buy myself cars, watches, but I switched off of that now. It's like I realized I was spending things on material items and not things on myself, on my being, on my fitness, on my health. I've switched that completely. Ali was one of my first heroes in combat sport. I watched documentaries on him, I read books on him. But even before I engaged in combat sport, I was interested in like the wrestling side of things, which is a lot more show.
Yeah.
And then obviously Muhammad Ali was a different animal because he was doing it for real.
Yeah.
Wrestling's not really for real, you know what I mean? But Muhammad Ali was doing it for real. And he was captivating the audience, he was entertaining, and he had passion and conviction. And I was just a young kid watching this, and then what got me into combat sport originally was as I grew older and began venturing outside my home and outside my estate. Again, like I said, Dublin 12, it's a wild old town. You've got to be able to fight. You've got to be able to defend yourself. So when I ventured out, conflict began happening, and I wanted to be prepared for that and be able for that. You know, that's false toughness. The tough guy does not last in the real
bullshit.
Game. You know what I mean? That's false. I look at the tough guys back then.
Yeah.
Where are they now?
Yeah.
They're not tough no more.
Yeah.
They ain't tough in their mother's box room, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I was not necessarily a tough grown up, but I was a hard worker, and I was smart. That's what I was. And wits beat toughness any day of the week.
That's
and
awesome.
Twice on Sunday. So I knew what I needed to do. I needed to learn combat sport. I needed to learn martial arts, gain confidence in surroundings, and then rise up, and that's what I done. Coming up, I look at, it's not trash talk to me, although it has in a way become that. I look at the opponent. I look, you know yourself to know others. That's a Bruce Lee quote. If you truly know yourself, you can know others. So I know what way I feel. I know what way that man feels. I know what I can say to push his buttons. I know what he's thinking. I know what he's afraid of. I know his worries, and I
put them under the spotlight. I put them out there. Yeah. I get them thinking about it. Yes. I made a Jose Aldo an undefeated champion. He was 28 years of age at the time. I made him feel like he was an old man. But he was 28 years of age. I went in, I told him what shot I was going to knock him out, and I knocked him out with that shot. So it's all psychological, to be honest. You've got to be able to control your breathing and control your emotions in there. Again, like I said, sometimes I've been up and down on it.
Sure, of course.
Sometimes I've riled up too much to it, and I'm only young, Tony, you know, I'm still learning the game.
Yeah.
And I don't claim to know it all. But what I do know, I know it damn well, you know, and I'm continuing to learn and continuing to push on. And that's where I'm at now, so. More external doubt. I love it. Give it to me. Give me all that doubt. Tell me I can't do something. Tell me I'm not gonna cross over and make that jump into a completely new sport. Not only against some random guy,
but
against
the
damn best. I'm very confident now, and my engine is keep building. As long as I keep on it and try and not slip and keep motivated. I think like your lack of commitment is almost an insult to the people who believe in you. And that's what I'm trying to tell myself. I said, there's people who believe in me. So this is what I'm telling myself right now, today. There's people that believe in me, and me having this half commitment, it's not who the fuck I am.
It's not what the people who
believe in me deserve. And I want to give back to the people who believe in me and give them that belief, you know, and prove that belief correct. So that's where we're at now, and let's see where it goes. I have seen a man die in this game. I was ringside. I cornered a man. I am humble in victory or defeat, no matter what. It's a sport at the end of the day. A gruesome sport, but it's a sport. So I respect it. I was defeated on the night. All in is a term I like to use in my ventures. All in. We've got to be all in on our ventures. I am all in on my whiskey. I'm all in on my clothing, my fitness regime, the McGregor Fast Program. I am all in on the fight game. I just want my worth. You know, there's a lot of politics in the game. The fight game is full of sharks, but I'm the fucking whale. It's hard work. That's it. Hard fucking work. You put it in, you believe in it, you will succeed. And that's it. I am living proof. If you want to look at a man who has clawed his way, fought with every ounce of his being to get to where he is, you're looking at him right here. You know, my family is a great family. I have a loving family, my mother, my father, my two sisters. But my lineage, the McGregor lineage, we are bled on the battlefield. You can trace my lineage back to the Highlands, where we fought invaders off of our land with our family sword, the claymore. It's wrapped in sheepskin, and I have it hanging on the banisters of my stairs just to remind me of where I come from and who I am. We are warriors, we are fighters.